Beloved, you're welcome to our teaching of the series that we have embarked upon as we continue in our study of the Gospel of John. Today, we shall commence the study of chapter 16 of this wonderful Gospel that seeks to reveal the person of Jesus to us more clearly, that we have an understanding of the words of Jesus Christ. Turn with me to John chapter 16. We read at verse 1. John chapter 16, commence reading at verse 1. I have said all these things to you to know, to keep you from falling away. They will put you out of the synagogues. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering service to God. And they will do these things because they have not known the Father nor me. But I have said these things to you, that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told them to you. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. But now I'm going to him who sent me. And none of you ask me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Concerning sin, because they do not believe in me. Concerning righteousness, because I go to the Father, and you will see me no longer. Concerning judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth, for he will speak on his own authority. But whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. This is the word of the Lord. Beloved, in our last study, we recall that Jesus was making the disciples, was preparing the mind of the disciples to know what it is that they will expect, or what they should expect. And Jesus said to them, he said they will be hated, and they should understand that they hated him first. And Jesus continues on that line of teaching in the beginning of this chapter. You should understand that this is Jesus preparing the mind of the disciples for his departure, and preparing the mind of the disciples for that which will happen, so that they will not be taken unawares. And the first thing Jesus said is that, I have said all these things to you to keep you from falling away. And Jesus is saying to them, he said, the reason why I'm telling you this is that when the persecution comes, you will not fall away, because it will most surely come. If there is anything that the believer in Jesus Christ should expect, is persecution. Persecution will surely come. And Jesus said that, I have said all these things to you to keep you from falling away. All these things I have said so that you will not fall away. They will put you out of the synagogue. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering service to God. And Jesus is making this so graphic. He's giving them an idea of what to expect, and is giving them a graphic detail of what to expect. And is saying that the persecution will be elevated to the point of the disciples being killed. And you will notice that all the disciples had a gruesome experience in the hands of the persecutor, perhaps except one who was meant to be killed but survived miraculously, but was left in the island of Patmos, where he got John the Beloved, where he was able to get the revelations that we have in the book of Revelation. But virtually all of them, including the Apostle Paul, died a gruesome death. And that seemed to be an example that the Lord is laying down for the disciple. He said, they will put you out of the synagogue. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering service to God. And it's happening in our time. We've seen people who have killed persons who testify the divinity of Jesus, the lordship of Jesus. We've seen them brutally killed. We've seen those who were killing, chanting and shouting victorious song as service unto the Lord. And we see in verse 3 that he said, they will do these things because they have not known the Father nor me. He said, but I have said these things to you, that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told them to you. He said, I have told you this thing. Note that I am telling you so that you will know that when it comes, I have already prepared. Your mind need to be prepared. So the believer needs to have a prepared mind. The prepared mind that the world out there will be hostile. The prepared mind that the system of the world antagonizes the system of God. Then Jesus said to them, he said, I did not say these things to you from the beginning. He said, there was a reason why I did not tell you when I called you to follow me so that I will make you fishers of men. There was a reason why I did not tell you these things. And what was the reason? He said, because I was with you. At this time, I am with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Now I am leaving you. And none of you ask me where you are going. You recall that Philip was asking at that time. So Jesus said, now, Philip was the one that saying, look, Thomas was the one that was saying, you kept saying, and he said, show us the Father. He said, you said we know the way. He was asking about the way. But here Jesus is saying, none of you is asking, where am I going to? And Jesus says to them, he said, because I have said this thing, these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. So the Bible, the word of Jesus still reminds us that even when Jesus was saying to the disciples that he was leaving and going to the Father, Jesus was saying, I will not leave you. I am still reassuring you. You notice that between chapter 14 and chapter 16, where we are right now, there is a repetition. Jesus keeps emphasizing that the Holy Spirit will come. The Holy Spirit will come. He is our helper. And It is very, very apparent from the teaching of Jesus Christ that the believer cannot do without the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is needed for victorious living. The Holy Spirit is needed for knowing the truth. The Holy Spirit is needed for guidance. The Holy Spirit is needed for joy, for conviction. The Holy Spirit is needed for everyday living, is what Jesus is emphasizing here. And he said, if I do go away, the helper will come to you. But if I go, I will send him. And when he comes, he will convict the world. So in ministry, oftentimes we make this error that we are the one who do the conviction. No, it is the Holy Spirit. We are only tools in the hands of God. And the Holy Spirit is the one who convict men. And Jesus said, the Holy Spirit will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. He says concerning sin because they do not believe in me. So it is the Holy Spirit who will bring the conviction that will make men to believe in Jesus Christ. And he said concerning righteousness because I go to the Father. The world will get to have right standing with the Father. Only because there is a conviction. Only because the Holy Spirit has brought about that conviction. And Jesus has gone to be with the Father. And you will see me no longer concerning judgment because the ruler of this world is judged. And he said, I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. And Jesus was seen speaking to his disciples, said, I have things to say, but you cannot bear this. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak of his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare them. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore, I say that he will take of what is mine and declare it to you. And this is very, very important for us to really, really understand that the help of the Holy Spirit is what the believer needs. The presence of the Holy Spirit in the life of the disciples. Of a disciple makes the difference. If the Holy Spirit is not in your life, you will not be able to experience victorious living that Jesus talks about. He says, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide. So his role is to guide us into all truth. And he will not speak of his own accord. He will not speak of his own authority. He will speak by the authority given to him by God. And whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. Beloved, we have authority. Even in the midst of persecution, even in the midst of the things that Jesus said will come our way, we should covet the presence of the Holy Spirit. No wonder David in the Old Testament understood this reality when he pleaded and said, Lord, take not thy Holy Spirit away from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation. He understood that the Holy Spirit is key to enjoying the joy of that salvation, of the Lord's salvation. And for us believers, even today, do not be shaken. The Lord wants us to know that first of all, as believers in Jesus Christ, as people who are disciples of Jesus Christ, the world will hate us, they will persecute us, and they will even dare to want to kill us as they have done to some persons. But Jesus reminds us that the helper will come, And the helper will strengthen us. The helper will encourage us. The helper will guide us. The helper will teach us. The helper will bring about conviction. The helper, the Holy Spirit, the one who helps us, will lead us into godliness, will lead us in righteousness, will bring conviction. So I pray that as many of you that have watched this broadcast today will know that whatever you're going through right now, all you need is the Holy Spirit in your life, and you shall be an overcomer, because His teaching, His guidance will bring victory. Thank you for listening to today's broadcast. We'll continue on our teaching on our next episode. God bless you.